What a year, what a year. New drone rules for the UK and Europe. Freedom to fly inside towns and cities with the right model. Easy certification, but still the sword of Damocles dangling over us with no new C classifications for any of the models released. No idea if they're going to be banished to open countryside in a year's time. DJI released a 90 mile an hour FPV drone. We had more lockdowns, then no lockdowns. Volcanoes erupted, travel opened up just at the right time to get some close encounters of the hot lava kind. Water, fire, ice, all making for some stunning shots. And after 3 years waiting, we finally got the supposed successor to the Mavic 2 Pro, only to find it was more overpriced unfinished symphony rather than groundbreaking replacement. But here we are, them's are the cards. So let's have a quick look at what happened and what we might look forward to in 2022. Hello everyone, I'm Ian and I play with drones, and 2021 was a year for some very new and different drones to play with. Although for those of us in the UK and in the European countries, we started the new year grappling with 172 pages of new rules that came into force on the 31st of December 2020. These unified most rules for most of us in Europe, and it actually brought in a new approach that focused on the size and the risk of the drone coupled with the proximity to crowds and the risk of the flight, which made perfect sense. But as ever, what could have been so simple was made so complex. And sadly, as of now, we're still left in a state of purgatory with all of our current models of drones possibly becoming relegated to only flying in open countryside at the end of 2022 because they lack the new numeric C classifications that the rules require. But look, a lot can change in a year, so let's see what happens. More importantly, let's have a look at what actually happened. What better way to start than looking at one of the ugliest, alien-like, loudest models that came with one of the shortest battery lives ever. And yet still, I loved it. The groundbreaking DJI FPV. And look, I say groundbreaking because for most non-FPV flyers, this really was a groundbreaking model. Rightly or wrongly, most non-FPV flyers would view FPV drones as simply a hardcore case in soldering and electronics with tiny battery lives and frankly more time spent fixing and repairing them than actually flying. The FPV did change this. It brought in the stabilized high definition camera and gimbal that most DJI flyers were used to into a really immersive world of genuinely exciting and impressively dynamic flying. Always with the safety net of that hard brake button that I have no doubt saved many an FPV from smashing into pieces. It was so different to anything I'd flown before, but the super short battery life really did frustrate me. But look, ultimately when you've got a drone that's traveling around at 60, 70 miles an hour, that's what happens. You plow through the juice and you end up with a super short battery life, so you can't really complain. But you can, because all this came at a price too, well over a grand, and you still only got one battery with that. But as I said at the time, you make your choice, you pay your money. That ability to freeze its motion in mid-flight when it was all about to go A over T was such a great function that it in itself saved me a truckload of repair bills. Then in April, we had this beast. DJI Air 2S, a huge 1-inch 20 megapixel sensor, top flight performance and the ability to fly in absolutely crazy strong winds, host of intelligent flight mode, 10-bit color, and really importantly, at a really reasonable price. As this drone really did prove itself, and in my opinion, it quickly gained its rightful place as the very best all-rounder that DJI produced. And when I say all-rounder, I definitely do not mean a jack of all trades and a master of none. No, that drone is and remains a top spec and top performance model. It's an absolutely amazing bit of kit. And as I said, at a very reasonable price. So it's no surprise that it became so popular so quickly. And it's also no secret that it's still my absolute favorite model as of now. When I was over in Iceland this year, it was the Air 2S that performed fantastically in every situation. Apart from, I should add, staring down into a volcano, because there was no way I was going to risk this amazing bit of kit with a load of red hot lava and crazy high temperatures. No, For those flights, I use the trusty old Mavic 2 Pro. For all those risky shots in Iceland, in fairness though, it produced fantastic shots and it performed incredibly well. Those clips went on to be used by Alexander Armstrong in Iceland, on Channel 5 in the UK, and also Jeff McIntyre for ABC Earth documentary right across the USA. So happy lad all round. But look, the only reason I was happy to use the 2 Pro for those risky shots is because I was under the impression this was soon to be replaced with a new model towards the end of the year. Sure enough, as autumn came round, the polarizing Mavic 3 was finally released. Ish, because if ever there was a lesson in how not to launch a new model, the Mavic 3 was it. Brilliantly spec'd model that has truly top-end engineering, let down by being hopelessly overpriced and launched with a mind-numbingly long list of stuff that just wasn't working, along with a brand new RC Pro controller that managed to piss off practically every single existing smart controller owner in the world. So I kind of find it a little bit ironic that DJI's last release of 2021 will probably end up being similar to the first release of 2021 too. Unpopular and misunderstood, because the Mavic 3 remains a very troubled model, I think. It goes nowhere near to genuinely upgrading and replacing the Mavic 2 Pro. You've got the bigger sensor and longer battery life, but it does still bring a level of performance and specifications, but albeit to me, frankly, crazy set of prices. So that actually brings me on to what we might look forward to coming up in the next year, because I do think there's a lot to ponder and wonder about. Will we finally get these new models launched with these new numeric C classifications? It's still a huge issue for a market that has got over twice the population of the USA. DJI is not exactly flavour of the month with the US government at the moment, is it? So I'm genuinely hoping that DJI are going to get these markings sorted very, very soon. As far as actual new releases go, I'm guessing Mini 3 is not too far away, especially given the enormous benefits that this gets under the EASA-based rules, because it's under 250 grams. Also wonder if there's going to be a smaller, lighter FPV on the cards. It's an incredible bit of kit, but frankly, it is just too big, too expensive, and way too easy to massively damage with any level of crash. So a smaller, lighter, cheaper FPV is defo needed, and I can't see this going unnoticed by DJI, frankly. Similarly, I am actually genuinely wondering if a slightly rebranded Mavic 3 Pro is on the cards at maybe a more realistic price, possibly making more of a new RC Pro controller bundle. Because there is no doubt that the Mavic 3 is a struggling model, but as I said, I think it's more to do with its launch than its actual specs, which genuinely are top specs. So it's a shame it's being let down by that. So I hope they get that sorted, but look, I hope we have quite a few surprises coming up. The Autel Nano is coming out very, very, very soon. I'll be looking at that one carefully. Its bigger sibling, the Evo 2 Pro, it's 3 years old. It's very much due for an upgrade as well. So look, as ever, let me know below what you think. What in the comments, tell me what you think of the 2021 releases and tell me what you're hoping for in 2022. This is where I get to see what you're thinking. And so I really, really do love going through all of the comments, even if I don't get to manage to answer every single one. Nice little year-end bonus sees me sneaking over the 50,000 subscriber mark, which I have to say is just brilliant. I'm usually a man who's more focused on numbers of views rather than subscribers, but I can't deny being pretty chuffed at getting to this milestone. 2022 sees me changing jobs, and I'll be having far more time to dedicate to filming and producing and reviewing for this channel. So I really am hoping to get a lot more videos out and trying to get more content on more of the models. Again, let me know in the comments below, tell me what floats your boat and what you want to see. Either way, look, I just wanted to say thank you for those of you that have helped me out, those of you that have made so many constructive comments and followed me along during the year. I really do love my little corner of YouTube, and I love that so many of you seem to like it too. So look, with that, I really do wish you all the very best for the coming year. And as ever, whatever you're doing, wherever you are, stay safe and sane, have fun, happy flying, happy new year.